What's up, guys? Welcome to another episode of Pat Taste Performance. Today here we have a Craftsman 208cc 24-inch two-stage snowblower with electric start. I actually did a repair on this. You've seen the other video, I had to get this thing running. So I just upsold him an impeller modification, aka we are going to supercharge this machine. Basically, what we're going to do here is that we are going to increase the throwing distance of the machine, and we are going to reduce the chances of the machine clogging up with heavy wet snow. Basically, this thing right here, this shovel, garbage. Throw it away. No, don't throw it away. Keep it with you. You never know. God forbid. So, a disclaimer before doing this, I will not be responsible for any damage that you do once you modify your machine, because if you pick up a rock or any small object, your machine is going to throw it now. So when you blow snow, be cognizant to keep it away from your house, your window, your car, anything of value. If it picks it up, it will throw it. It will throw it. So, tools for today. Okay, we have a little small 3/8 extension, 11 millimeter or 7/16 to buzzle up the bolts for the chute base. Okay, and then the 13 miller, we're going to take out the bolt. 13 miller, we're going to take out this bolt right here, and it's going to pop off the chute so we can have access to the impellers. Okay, I'm going to be using my Milwaukee drill to run the sheet metal screws down. Okay, a 5/16 magnetic socket. Actually, I got this from Harbor Freight. I actually got the whole set. So, yeah, very helpful tool. Okay, my snap-on, low-profile 7/16 or 11mm socket to do the other top two bolts. Sometimes I have a lot of clearance. Okay, so I use sheet metal screws with washers, so it's two per impeller. We have three impellers, we need a total of six. Okay, Stanley tin snips, so it's easier to cut the mud flap. And some measuring tape. See how much we have to measure the impeller and cut. So let's get this video started. Let's get the machine here. Alright, so let's buzz off these four bolts in the chute housing. So we have two on the bottom, which we can see here. Now remember, we got to support it from the back. It's going to be hard for me to film, but support these from the back because they're carriage bolts. And you don't want to strip them out. When I say by carriage bolts, you guys see, this bolt has a shoulder, like a square. And once I take off the chute base, I'll explain to you what a carriage bolt and how it works. So that's one. Now we gotta do the other two. The other one on the base. Okay, take that there. Okay. Alright, now we're gonna do the two on the top. I don't know if you guys can see these two here, those are the two we have to take off. So actually my ratchet can't get that, so we are going to use my low profile socket set. You guys can see that. Okay, so this isn't obviously as fast as doing it with the ratchet, but it is what it is. I'm not turning it by hand. Alright, one more to go. Actually, I should be able to get that one. Alright, support it from the bottom. I'll zip it out. See? What a difference. What a time difference. Now if you can't reach the bolt, just move the impeller over. Push down on it the way it spins, because the impeller spins clockwise. I'm sorry, counterclockwise. But push it down anyway. You can push it. Alright, so now let's pull the shoot base out. Just pull it out and down. Okay. And here we have the impellers enclosed, but we don't have a straight shoot at it. So let's set the machine to dead center. So we know. So everything lines up. Dead center. And we're going to remove the 13 millimeter bolt. Number 13. Now when we tighten this bolt, you gotta remember, don't make it too tight. You know if you will make it too tight, because then you won't be able to move the chute at all. So then you just back it off. Alright, you see here we have the impeller completely exposed? You see this gap here? This is where the snow gets clogged up and caught up. We're gonna get rid of that gap. So we have three impellers, so let's get our measuring tape. And let's see, this thing should be about 2.5 inches wide. Let's see if I'm right. Yep, 2.5 inches from here to here. You really can't put it up here because then you won't have a good base to screw down. So from here to here is 2.5. We're going to cut it a little wide because we want it to overhang. We want it to overhang here. So once we cut it, modify it to have perfect, perfect adhesion. Let's get my mud flap. Let's start here. Let's make sure you guys can see this. Yep, so 2.5. I'm going to cut it a little more. Okay. You see how I'm putting this in here? You see a gap? No gap. And you want a little bit to overhang. Because that you want it to wear. You want a little bit of excess. Don't go crazy, but you want a little bit of excess. Take our drill. Alright, make sure we get a good bite here. You know, don't screw it towards the end. You wanna give it some depth. So screw it down right there. Try and drill straight down on an angle. Not on an angle, just straight down. Start off slow. Okay, you see that? See how we made that mark? Not enough to fight with the mud flap no more. See how we made the mark? So now just follow that with the drill. And that's why I like magnetic. See how it holds in? If I was using a regular socket, I would have been a disaster. Come on. There we go. It got a bite. So now, it will be smooth sailing. This tip not sharp enough. Anyway, it's going to take a couple of tries, but in the end, it's going to be well worth it. Buzz right through. We're going to take our impeller. There we go, stick the washer right through like this. Alright, now we're going to go to the impeller, find it, start it, and we're going to lock it down. Now don't make it too tight, because then you don't want to rip the impeller, and then you'll rip it in general. Once you hit the activator, you're going to rip it right off. You don't want to do that. You just want to rip You want the machine to adhere to the impeller, so you just want to do a small part of it. So we're going to get our second impeller. See? Right down. Alright? See, as you guys can see, as I'm screwing this sheet metal screw down, I'm supporting the bottom of it with my other hand. Now, this impeller, you see how it's going to move? It's going to go, the impeller is going to throw snow this way, so it's going to cycle this way, so we can move it up. So now what we're going to do now is we don't want to put too much stress on the machine or the impeller. We're going to start it and maybe run for about 2 seconds with the auger engaged, just enough to break this in here, but not enough where it'll fully break in. Go from there. That's it. Now perfect. It's right at our next impeller. So remember, we did 2.5. So let's do that again. See how we're rotating the impeller? Turn it away from you. Okay, see how that's nice and smooth? So what happens is, this is your impeller. We're cutting it wide, right? So now, as it's going through the machine, it's gonna bend, like so, okay? It's gonna work its way around the machine in a circular motion, like this, and once it comes to the opening, right, watch what's going to happen. It's going to release. See how it flicks up? That's what it's going to do. It's going to literally flick your snow away. Flick the slush right out. And then what happens, when the impeller is worn perfectly, it's not going to be, see how we cut this straight? It's actually going to be worn on an angle. Because don't forget, it's almost like a blender, you know, screwing around. And we're going to fling this thing. We're gonna leave, see, no gap, gap, no gap, make sure it's gone, and we're gonna let it overhang just a little bit. Alright, so I'm gonna support it from the bottom with your other hand, straight down. We have our metal dot. See here? That's where the sheet metal screw went, and that's where we got to continue to drill. Right through the impeller. Sheet metal screw, washer it up, stick it in there, there you go, snug, not gorilla tight, because remember, you don't want to push and rip through the impeller, because then you're going to nullify this modification and the whole thing is going to rip right in. Now, the reason why I choose sheet metal screws is one, it's easier, it's quicker, and number two, think about what's always exposed in here, metal, so it's going to rust. So a lot of people who nut and bolt them, you know what's going to happen? When they ever go to remove them, because these paddles will wear down over time, I mean a lot of usage, they're going to snap. So we're going to stop that from snapping. Alright, so forget, we're going to start it up. Thank you. back so we can move the impeller around. Now remember, we're going to move the impeller in its natural flow direction. I'm going to cut our last piece because there's three impellers. Okay, remember? Gap, no gap, and leave some overhang. Alright, that's it. So you guys can see our close up. Oh, that's not a good angle. It's not focusing. But they're not tight. You see how they're not wedged all the way in? Just a little bit. So this is going to be the final basic step now. We're going to get everything lubed up real, real nice. Excuse the mess. There we go. So, any type of lubricant. I'm using track lube. You could use anything, WD-40, PAM, you could use PAM, because remember, oil and water don't mix, and plus you don't want to stress out the impellers. So spray it all inside this machine, all inside the chute housing, you got it. So all inside the chute housing, you gotta go. Oh, did I lose you guys? Alright, now I didn't lose you guys. Alright, sorry about that. My father was calling. I will call him back. So, yep, so we're gonna do the final break-in. And I'll explain to you why we have the carriage bolts in there. Carriage bolts. You see how we have these square ports here? That's where the carriage bolt locks into. That's why we need to support it from the back. You do not want to strip these out or else you're going to have a bad day. Alright, you see that? How it locks in? Because this right here is a lower profile compared to a regular nut and bolt. So, remember, you got to put the chute first. Slide that in. Remember, we did this dead center, so it's lined up. Take the bolt. Start it by hand, because that's a 13 millimeter. We will not tighten that. Okay, slide the base back in. All right, and then we're going to do the. Then we're going to stick the base housing bolts in. Two in the top. You want to buy. Now, it doesn't matter what you do first. I like to do the bottom first. So just rotate that. Make sure if it's flush, you know you're locked in. So turn these as much as you can by hand. You don't want to make them all tight as soon as you do them, because then you won't be able to line up the rest of the holes. So we will stick them in there. Yep, perfect. right there, make sure we're holding it and we're supporting it. Okay, and then we're gonna do the top two. So the same thing, I'll take you over to the top. Remember, supporter from the bottom. Now we can't access the chute from that. The last one, so remember, we turn the impeller by hand. I use both hands, so it's easier to move around. Okay. Now, because they're in there, we could do these using your ratchet or the hand, but remember, we still have to support the bottom. So remember this one I was able to do with the ratchet, grab it by the bottom. You can feel with your fingers that it's fluff. And lock it down. Don't make that tight too, because then you're going to break the plastic housing. Since I have my ratchet in my hand, we're going to do the two side bases as well. So I will attach part one to this, I guess, because the guy couldn't get his snowblower started, so I showed you guys how I repaired that for him. But anyway, let's get this thing started. Now we're actually going to have the rubber impellers fly out, so you want to make sure away from you. You're actually going to hear the impeller smack around. See how guys went from wider to louder to quiet? That means your impellers are perfectly worn in. And as you can see, we got little chunks here that came out, which is fine. You want that. And then you can see inside the chute, there's also a black residue from the impeller. And then if you look inside, I'm going to take this up. If you look inside here, see how you have black, red, black? That means it's perfect adhesion. It's wiping a clean path throughout the entire machine, except for that area where the impeller isn't. So that's exactly what we wanted. So this machine is good to go for the next snowstorm. You know what? I am actually going to attach a video of my Snow Tek Arians 208-24cc that I did about three houses in less than 30 minutes. And this was, you know, some wet, slushy snow. And did awesome, didn't clog up, and made some real quick, easy money. All right, guys. So if you guys found this video helpful, entertaining, anything positive, please like, please subscribe. Do not hesitate to comment. Oh, yeah, do that both. Do not hesitate to comment and share if you need. Remember, let's tighten this down. You can't make it too tight or else it won't move. So, perfect. So, like I was saying before, like, share, subscribe if you found this video informal and helpful. Okay, any questions, feel free to ask. Any comments, good or bad, do not hesitate to comment. So, I will see you guys on the next video for Pat Tay's performance.